Hello, welcome to the Viewmasters. Batman Braven the Bold, episode 24, The Fate of Equinox. My name is Sho.
My name is Eric.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm okay. How are you?
I am okay.
Good.
As well.
All right.
Everybody's okay.
Everybody is okay.
The kids are all right.
For the purposes of this podcast, everything's fine.
Everything is great. Fate of Equinox.
Fate of Equinox.
Yes.
Has two meanings.
Uh-huh.
One, because Equinox is our villain again.
Yes.
And,
is it Equinox or Equinox?
I think it depends on what happens when I open my mouth.
Okay, so it's not a conscious thing?
Nope.
Okay. Alright.
So Equinox is the villain?
Because I think equine, I think a horse.
Sure.
But is horse the root of Equinox?
I don't know. Maybe.
I don't know either. That's weird. Is
again,
it a balance of horses?
Horse latitude?
I don't know. What is that?
I don't know, but isn't the equinox kind of a directional kind of thing? And then like the center of the globe?
Something like that. Yeah. I know it's when the night and the day are the exact same amount of time.
Right.
Is the equinox.
Yes.
I don't know that it has anything to do with horses.
Okay.
But it very well may.
Could be.
Yeah.
I don't know. Horses are crazy creatures.
I'm not a horse girl, so I don't know.
I'm also not a horse girl.
Yeah.
In fact, I am deathly allergic to horses.
They say as if you don't know the horse girl, you are the horse girl. There's always a horse girl. At least in grade school, there was always a horse girl.
I don't know what any of this means.
No? The girl is really into horses?
Okay.
No? I dated a horse girl once.
Did you?
Yeah, I did.
And then you married her, and
no,
her name is Jenny.
No, she's not a horse girl.
I have never heard of this.
Really?
No.
Google horse girl when we're done here.
I'm so afraid to.
It's not that... I guess it might be scary, depending on how your safe search filters are.
They are off.
I figured, so... Alright. I'll Google it. Send it to you. Because mine is set to moderate.
I don't self-censor.
Yeah, no, you shouldn't. So, Equinox is the villain.
Yep.
The horse girl is the villain. But also the guest star is Dr. Fate.
That's right.
Yes, the Fate of Equinox.
Both of them are in the title.
Yeah.
Yeah. Of course, we also have a cold open.
Yeah, we did.
Which also kind of ties into everything that happened today.
They tend to do that.
Yeah, they do sometimes.
On this show.
It's weird.
Yeah, it's like they're thinking when they write these things.
Like maybe they plan it out a little.
Yeah. That's odd.
That is very odd. So our cold open is one of the very few that doesn't have a guest star in it.
Yeah, well, yeah. He teams up, but it doesn't have a guest hero.
No. It's that Batman is raiding somebody's headquarters. We don't know who.
Mm-hmm.
Although there's a clue in the establishing shot. Which I did not get until after the identity of the villain had been revealed.
Yeah, was it the Double Dip Cone Company?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. My first thought was Mr. Freeze.
Yeah.
Has Mr. Freeze been on this yet?
Mr. Zero has, but I don't think Mr. Freeze has.
Only in one of the cameos.
In one of the cameos,
okay.
Yeah.
All right.
It's only a matter of time.
Sure.
Did you watch The Flash last night?
I did not.
Okay.
Not yet.
Okay.
Yeah.
I won't spoil it for you, but you'll love it.
Okay, then.
The thing that I was about to mention, you will love. And you'll know it exactly when you hear it.
Okay, then. I look forward to that. I'll probably watch it after you leave tonight.
All right.
So, yeah, so Batman raids a villain's headquarters, and said villain turns out to be Two-Face.
Yeah! Harvey Two-Face.
Harvey Two-Face. Of all the terrible things that have come out of the Joel Schumacher Batman movies. Movies that I love, by the way.
Yeah.
Harvey Two-Face is the worst.
So dumb.
Yep.
Just Two-Face, guys.
Yep. And also, Harvey Dent, played by a black man originally.
Mm-hmm.
What's with all the whitewashing?
Yeah.
Billy Dee. Yeah,
he got screwed on that.
He
one.
Got screwed. I would have liked to have actually seen him as Two-Face.
I mean, he got paid for it.
I'm sure he did.
Yeah.
But still.
They bought him out of his contract so
right.
they could have someone else be Two-Face.
It was dumb.
Yeah, it was dumb.
Because Tommy Lee Jones was terrible as Two-Face.
Yeah, he wasn't great.
Also, the whole gimmick of Two-Face is that one side is handsome and one side is scarred up.
Yeah.
And Tommy Lee Jones is the ugliest man alive.
Oh, man. That is rough.
All of his face is scarred. There needs to be a difference.
That was like the height of Tommy Lee Jones fame, too, wasn't
it? Was.
It was right
it
after
really
The Fugitive.
Was. Yep.
Wow.
And all he did was a Jack Nicholson impression.
Basically, yeah.
He just played the Joker.
Yeah. Which is weird, because the Riddler also played the Joker.
Kind of. It was slightly different.
Yeah.
Different enough.
Yeah.
Yeah. I did like his costume in that movie, though.
Two-Faces?
Yeah.
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 I for some reason, the past couple of days, I have had the final riddle from Batman Forever stuck in my head.
Alright.
I don't know why.
Okay.
I've just always thought it was really clever.
Alright.
Do you want to know what it is?
It's a bat.
It's not a bat.
Oh, okay.
No. We're five little items of an everyday sort. You'll find us all in a tennis court.
Alright.
It's vowels.
Yeah.
This is a really clever riddle.
That is very clever.
Yeah.
I do enjoy that.
Good job, movie.
Yeah.
See? Good job, Will Shorts of the New York Times, who wrote all the riddles for the movie.
Did he?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right. Did not know that.
I think he's the crossword puzzle editor.
Yes. Yeah.
Sorry.
All right.
Yeah.
Two-Face.
Two-Face is the villain, yes.
Yes. Voiced by Dexter's dad.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Nice.
James Remar.
I didn't really pay close attention to the credits at the end, so.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah. But, yeah, so Batman is fighting Two-Face, who apparently is half good and half evil, which...
Well, yeah, more or less.
I guess? I don't know.
I mean, that's how the coin thing works.
Sort of.
Yeah.
I mean, to me, the coin has always been, when it comes up unscarred, he just doesn't do the horrible thing that he wants to do.
Yeah.
Which I wouldn't necessarily call good.
That's true. That's neutral. Fair enough. All right.
Because usually he starts the coin toss with evil intentions.
Yeah, it's true. The only thing stopping him is the coin toss.
Right.
Yeah. All right. I'll buy that.
All right. Although, on the other hand, you know, how the setup works out, one could say that, I guess, he did do good. And that, you know, he's flipping the coin to see if they're going to kill Batman.
Mm-hmm.
And it turns up unscarred. So he then teams up with Batman to take out his goons.
Well, I think he only does that because the goons decide that they still want to kill Batman regardless of what the coin says.
Right.
Because he says something about nobody double-crosses Two-Face.
Okay. All right.
So... I mean, it was still an odd turn of events.
It was a very odd turn of events.
Yeah.
It sort of reminded me of, you read the Batman 66 Lost episode.
Mm-hmm.
The Harlan Ellison written, Two-Face.
Oh, Harlequin Ellis? He's one of my favorite writers.
Harlequin Ellis.
Yeah.
Yep.
Google it, kids.
Yep. Like, his whole shtick in that was that, like, he would commit a crime, but then he would, like, return what he stole.
Yeah.
It was weird.
It was weird, yeah. Like, he did it, and then he had thief's remorse.
Right.
Afterwards. Like, oh, guys, I'm really sorry. I feel so bad about this. He's just extremely bipolar. Two-Face.
Yeah, kind of. Two-Face is one of my favorite Batman villains.
I really like Two-Face as well. Yeah.
So it was just nice to see him show up in this.
Yeah, that was cool.
And I do enjoy the Dick Sprang appearance of the show in general, but something about the way Dick Sprang always drew Two-Face always appealed to me.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know why.
It's like the orange and purple suit.
That's always nice, too. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nothing against other versions of Two-Face except for Tommy Lee Jones.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Good stuff. Good cold open.
Yeah. So then we get into the rest of the episode, and it's the final battle with Equinox.
Mm-hmm.
Equinox.
Yeah, either way. Horse girl.
It's the final battle with Equus.
Yes. Oh, naked Daniel Radcliffe?
Yep.
It's Batman and Dr. Fate versus Harry Potter and his penis.
The sorcerer's penis.
It's his magic wand. Expelliarmus. Yeah, so it opens with Batman having gone to somewhere in Mexico, I'm assuming?
I think.
Looked like sort of Aztec-y architecture.
Seemed like it.
Yeah. Somewhere in Central America, South America. I don't know. I'm terrible with all that.
He's at
history.
An Aztec or Incan or Mayan temple.
Yes. Yeah. Sorry, everyone. And Equinox is there, Batman climbs to the top of the temple, and the ground tumble or the top sort of crumbles away, and it reveals a giant like a gyroscope.
Yep. The ninth wonder of the world, apparently.
Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
Which, what's the eighth wonder of the world?
I don't know.
They skipped over one.
Gorilla Grodd.
Gorilla Grodd is the eighth wonder of the world. All right.
Only because he has substituted him for King Kong.
Yeah. But yeah, the legend has it that the gyroscope, as long as it runs, the world will continue to spin.
Yep.
And if it should ever stop, the world will stop as well.
Yep.
So,
apparently that's Equinox's plan?
That is Equinox's plan.
To stop the world.
He will plunge half of the world into a blazing hot eternal day.
Yep.
And the other half of the world into a freezing final night.
Yep. I guess that's how that works?
I guess so. If the Earth stops spinning, that makes sense.
I guess.
It would still be revolving around the sun, so...
Yeah.
Maybe it would, you know... The position of the sun would move in that respect, but very slowly.
Yeah.
I don't know. Like, you get 6 months of darkness and 6 months of light.
Right. Like Alaska.
Like Alaska, exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
Steve Niles.
Yeah. Why do you hate it?
I treat my fellow creators terribly, and I don't plan on ever making it in this industry.
Well, part of that's true.
Yeah.
Batman obviously not a fan of that plan.
No. I don't understand why not.
He's
a night guy.
That's true.
If there was half the world in eternal night, you just go nuts.
And also, his opposition to this sort of is predicated on Batman buying into the belief that this gyroscope is what keeps the Earth spinning?
Well, sure.
So, Batman is very superstitious.
Well, he's a superstitious and cowardly lot.
He is. He strikes fear into the heart of himself.
He does.
And Dr. Fate is there to assist.
Yep.
For moral support.
Yep.
He fights some animated or stone snake things that have come to life.
Griffins, almost?
Griffins.
I don't know.
Gryffindor. Harry Potter. Back to attack us. But yeah, so they all fight, and Batman knocks Equinox into the gyroscope.
Yep.
And destroys the gyroscope.
Yep.
Did he? It seems sort of like he did it on purpose, which is not a Batman thing to do.
Not usually.
Yeah.
Yeah. And he really didn't make any effort to try to save him or anything. He just lets him fall to his death.
He didn't think anything would happen. Like, oh, that gyroscope looks pretty soft.
Right?
It'll cushion his fall. Batman's pretty dumb.
Yeah. Well, he believes that a giant gyroscope is causes the Earth to rotate.
That's true. We've been giving him far too much credit.
You know, I'm going to skip ahead to the sort of climax of this episode.
Okay, that's good. Because this episode was kind of boring.
Yeah.
I'll be honest.
Yeah. Yeah, there's a lot of talk about fate and chaos and order
and chaos, yeah.
Yeah, and I like Dr. Fate as a character. Like,
yeah.
I really do, and I think primarily, I don't know if I've talked about this here yet, but primarily comes from the fact that it was the first superpowers figure that I ever owned.
Yeah.
And his name was Kent, which is my brother's name.
Oh, nice. Is your brother's middle name Nelson?
No.
Oh.
Yeah. But at the time, I had never heard the name Kent used anywhere other than in reference to my brother.
Yeah.
And so I thought that was cool.
That is cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's rarely used as a first name.
Very rarely, yeah. Although,
Kent Brockman,
yesterday a brand new television show started, called Wicked City.
Yeah.
And, the semi-lead character of that show, apparently his name is Kent.
Okay. The character's name is Kent?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Did you watch that show?
I watched, way more of it than I shoulda.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I heard it was pretty bad.
It was pretty goddamn terrible. Feel really bad for Jeremy Sisto.
Yeah.
He is in a lot of terrible things. But he is really good. And I enjoy him.
Yeah.
He's just in a lot of shit. Including Wicked City.
Probably for not very long.
Hopefully. Alright, I'll just have to remember to switch the channel next week after S.H.I.E.L.D. Which I'm also still not sure why I'm watching.
Yeah. But
it's there.
It's been decent this
season. It has been decent.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I'll give it that. It's been an improvement. I'm just waiting for the dip.
I hear people say that Gotham has gotten better, but those people are wrong. Because I've watched the first two episodes of this season.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh. And it's not good.
Yep. I don't know how many episodes there have been.
Six at this point, I think.
I have watched the majority of those because my dad watches that show, and I am usually at my parents' house on Monday nights.
Yeah,
and yeah, it's not good.
Yeah,
yeah.
The kid that plays Jerome,
yes,
is constantly fluctuating between impressions of different Jokers.
And
is awful.
And also, there's a Joker on the show.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
20 years before there's supposed to be a Joker, which means that by the time that little baby Batman grows up and meets the Joker, he's going to say, well, hey, it's like that one guy that we knew that one time.
I recognize you, Jerome.
Spoiler, Jerome dies.
Oh, does he?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, he gets murdered the shit out of that.
Great. When was that? Was that recently?
Yeah, it was whatever the last most recent episode I watched was.
Okay. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Because I hate him so much.
No, yeah, so he's dead.
Good.
So he's not the Joker.
Okay, good.
So, yeah, it's... But still, very much like the Joker.
Yeah.
And apparently his death causes some sort of Joker-like virus to spread throughout Gotham City.
What?
And causes everybody to go crazy and laugh maniacally.
What?
Like Jokers.
What?
So again, I point that little baby Batman's gonna grow up and meet the Joker, and why would that be a big deal? When, as little baby Batman,
yeah,
he has already dealt with the Joker.
Yeah. Oh, that's weird. This is just like that thing that happened to me 15 years ago.
Right?
Yeah.
That show's fucking awful.
Yeah, it's so bad.
Dad likes it, though.
Yeah. Well, that's good.
Maybe
he likes that. He did not like the Adam West Batman.
Nope.
Difference of opinions.
Yep. This is the fundamental difference between me and my dad.
Grim and gritty.
Yep. One might say that we're not in balance.
No, you might say that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Fast forward to the end. Equinox has killed the Lords of Chaos and Order, I guess.
Oh, yeah, by falling into the gyroscope, Equinox becomes omnipotently powerful.
Yep.
Basically.
Yeah. Because basically his body was just a candy-coated shell of balance, and his chocolatey goodness on the inside is craze balls.
Is chaos.
Yes. So yeah, he kills the, I guess he kills the Lords of Order and Chaos. Yeah,
does he kill, he absorbs their essence or something?
Sure.
Yeah. They're probably fine at the end.
Yeah.
We don't know.
We don't find out.
Yeah.
At all.
It doesn't matter.
Nope.
They were exposition machines.
Yep. So yeah, so he becomes a giant with a crazy costume.
Mm-hmm.
And so Batman and Dr. Fate decide that the only way to beat him is to also be a giant in a crazy costume.
Mm-hmm.
So they gather up all of Batman's best friends.
Yes. All of his best friends. Including Fire?
Yep. One of his best. One of his best. Including
Jay Garrick.
Jay Garrick, yep.
Black Canary.
Yep, yeah. Hal Jordan.
Hal Jordan,
who
of course.
I don't think has appeared.
Has not been on the show yet.
Because every Green Lantern we've seen is usually Guy Gardner.
Yeah.
And maybe Kilowog.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Green Arrow. Of course, his best friend.
His bestest.
Yeah.
Blue Beetle.
Yeah.
Plastic Man.
Aquaman.
Scott Aquaman.
Oh. Have they done that one yet?
I don't think they have.
Okay.
And they're gonna steal all their powers.
Mm-hmm.
Borrow. And they're gonna stick them in Batman's body.
Mm-hmm.
All their powers, including Green Arrow's powers.
Yes. Well, he said powers and skills.
Okay. All right.
So all yeah. Right.
Oh yeah, Red Tornado is also.
Oh yeah, Red Tornado is there. Yeah.
And yeah, so they put all of those abilities into Batman, and he becomes a giant super adaptoid.
Yeah, or a Mazo.
Yeah. And the very first thing that he does now that he can face Equinox in combat, it punch him.
Well, yeah. You go with what you know first and see how that goes. Like, all right, I'm in my comfort zone. Bobbing and weaving.
Yep. There is a lot of bobbing and weaving.
There is.
For like about 20 seconds, the show becomes a video game.
Yeah.
Like a really boring video game.
Yeah. Like a side scroller.
Yeah.
Because they were just punching back and forth.
Yep.
It's Mortal Kombat.
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty much.
Like a really tame Mortal Kombat.
Street Fighter.
Yeah, there you go. Hawkeye!
Yeah. Is that from Street Fighter?
Yeah.
What is a Street Fighter? I've never even heard of that.
No.
Ha 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 ha. I was surprised by how little destruction there was with two Godzilla-sized creatures
right
fighting in the middle of town.
Yeah. I mean, there was an attempt.
There was an attempt, yeah. And I appreciate that, unlike a certain Man of Steel, Batman moved the fight out of a populated city.
Right. There were no 9/11s here today.
No.
Almost, though.
It was more of an 825.
Right?
I don't know what that is. Just a not as bad 9/11. Because it's smaller numbers.
Yeah.
An earlier date.
It's a couple weeks before.
Yeah. A 7/13, if you will.
It's almost 2 months.
I know, right? So much better.
Yep. We all remember.
7/13?
Yep.
I'll never forget it. It's a beautiful July day.
Yep.
But yeah, they take the fight out into space.
Yep.
And there's more punching.
Yep.
And energy blasts. And Batman uses his Iron Man powers. He fires some sort of energy beam from a circle in his chest.
Yeah. I was a little confused about that myself.
Yeah.
I think that was supposed to represent Dr. Fate's amulet?
Maybe?
Yeah.
There are powers that Batman had that he did not use.
Right.
He did not use the Canary Cry.
Nope.
He did not use Super Speed.
Not a bit.
Which, what the fuck, Super Speed is the best power, obviously.
Yep.
Yeah. He didn't use Tornado Wing.
Nope.
I don't know. It was fun to see him stretching and Green Lanterning and...
Right.
Stuff arrowing. Like that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Vigilanteing.
No, he's Green Arrow.
That's right,
now.
I'm sorry, he's the Green Arrow.
Yep.
Totally different guy.
Totally different dude.
No one will ever know.
Nope.
Except for everyone.
And he also talks like 4 pitches higher now. Yeah,
that's true.
Yep.
Yeah. I'm the Green Arrow. You have failed this city. Golly! Anyway.
Anyhow. Hey, let's talk about Mr. Trivik.
You want to talk about Mr. Trivik?
Yeah. Alright.
Is his name... What's his name?
In the show?
Yeah.
Curtis Holt.
Curtis Holt. Why is his name Curtis and
I don't
not
know.
Michael?
Yeah, and why is he gay?
Is he gay? I didn't know that.
Yeah, he mentions going on a vacation
that's
with
right.
his husband.
That's
his
right.
His first appearance. Yeah.
I forgot about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, why is he, why, like...
I don't care that he's gay or not.
I don't care that he's gay. I care more that they changed his name.
Right, it doesn't make any sense. Why?
It's totally arbitrary.
Maybe because Curtis sounds more black.
Does it?
Curtis Blow.
What?
Curtis Blow.
Who was that?
I don't want to say a rapper or a singer from, like, the late 70s, early 80s.
No idea.
Alright, then.
Okay.
We're getting into some racist territory.
Yeah, I'm not, I'm not familiar with it, so
right,
I can't comment.
Right.
But also, I don't know.
Alright.
Yeah, it's just...
But no, yeah, why would they change his name?
Change.
Why?
Yeah.
There's no point to it.
Yeah.
Unless Curtis dies and then his brother Michael shows up.
Maybe.
And assumes his duties as Mr. Terrific. Uses the T-spheres.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Yeah, or maybe his husband's name is Michael.
It could be. Could
yeah.
be as well. All I know is in the comics he's supposed to be like the best at everything, and
yeah.
in the show he doesn't seem that good at anything.
Yeah, he's what, like the third smartest man in the world, or
something like that. Yeah,
yeah.
And like an Olympic athlete, and yeah,
because
that's what Mr. Terrific is.
Yeah, and on Arrow he's a low level IT guy.
Yep, pretty much
for Palmer Tech.
Yep. yeah, he's just kind of smart.
Yeah.
Kind of smart for the Arrow universe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like having the, I guess he knows that he works for the Arrow now.
Right.
Like, I liked it the one time, I guess, last episode, where it was very much like in season one when Oliver would go to Felicity and ask for random weird stuff.
Right.
And I really liked that.
Yeah.
Because she did that to him. So, but they, you know, he knows now, so right. Never mind.
Yeah. Because at this point now, it's just a matter of time before everyone's wearing stupid-looking masks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Do you think he'll get that helmet that Diggle wears?
I hope not.
Because yeah, it's sort of got like a T thing on it.
It does.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Did they give Diggle a code name yet?
No, I don't think so. Yeah.
Why didn't they go, like, Guardian?
That right.
Because, you know, Mal Duncan was the Guardian briefly in the Teen Titans back right. in the late 70s.
It's possible.
So, I don't know. Like, put another black character in there.
Right. The Manhattan Guardian.
There you go. Yeah. Oh, that's even better.
Right.
That's more recent, even.
Right.
People might actually know what I'm talking about. I prefer to go with the oblique references to the Teen Titans from the late 70s.
Hey, no problem. We all have our niches.
Yeah, you know.
Everybody knows who Mal Duncan is.
Yeah. Did you know that guy, the guy that plays Diggle, Ramsey, whatever his name is, has been...
Doug Ram?
Not Doug, that's Cannonball.
It's not Cannonball, it's Cypher.
Oh shit, you're right.
Yeah.
But yeah, that guy has been around for a really long time.
Yeah.
Yeah, I did not know that.
Yeah.
I assumed that he was, you know, like in his maybe late 30s and...
Much older than that?
I think he's in his 40s.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, I've seen him in tons of stuff over the years.
Yeah.
But, you know, I know him best as Deborah's boyfriend for half a season on Dexter.
Oh my god, I totally forgot about that.
Yeah.
Wow.
He got skinned.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's messed up.
Kinda.
Yeah.
He survived it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's still skinning.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, wow, I totally forgot about that.
The Jimmy Smith season.
That's why I forgot about that. Because that season is not great.
It's alright.
It's not great.
It's better.
It's sandwiched between the two best seasons of the show.
I'll give you that. Definitely give you that, and I will say that it is also better than most everything after season 4.
Yeah, I will give you that as well.
Yeah.
No, I happened to turn on a terrible Matthew Perry movie from 1997
okay.
called 3 to Tango.
All right.
In which he is an architect working for Dylan McDermott Mulroney.
Yep.
And he pretends to be gay for some reason, like there's a misunderstanding.
Right.
So it is not aged well at all.
Can't imagine.
But he plays one of Matthew Perry's friends in that movie. And I was like, oh my god, it's Diggle.
Wow.
What is he doing here?
Huh.
Yeah. Would have been really young then.
Probably.
He was pretty young. Probably in his 20s. Anyway.
Yeah.
Those were my thoughts on Diggle.
All right.
John Diggle.
John Diggle's fine.
I like him.
I hate that fucking helmet, though.
Not a helmet, it's a mask. It only goes back this far on his head. It's like a Halloween mask you would get at the Target.
It's the worst.
It's pretty bad.
Yeah. Alright, I think we're...
They defeat Equinox in the end.
Yep, pretty much. the only interesting thing that I have to say about this episode is that Equinox is voiced by Odette Fair.
Yeah.
Who did the voice of Dr. Fate in the Justice League cartoons.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. So...
Who voiced Dr. Fate?
Some guy by the name of Greg Ellis.
Okay.
Never heard of him.
Just some voice actor.
Most likely.
Okay.
Yep. He was not great.
Yeah, he wasn't great.
Yeah.
Like super slow.
Yeah.
Kind of annoying.
Pretty annoying.
Alright.
Alright.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I'll see you next week.
Thank you for listening to The Viewmasters. You can subscribe to the show directly at view.guttertrash.net or at iTunes and leave us a review. Visit view.guttertrash.net for email information and links to Facebook and Twitter. We'll see you next time on The Viewmasters.